15, I did not have enough time for my caution. So, on that note, good morning. Welcome to the first honor award here in the administration. I told them not to make me the MC because I wouldn't have a floor. And I would take all those awards, which I think I really deserve. Because I think I know something about accounting. I can spell it. And I think I know about MBA and an MPA program. That they will require about the word degree. And I think I know something about business management. And when I know that, I will let you know. Right? So, welcome again. And as the person who's doing the greeting, I am going to say something briefly, and then I shall turn your attention to our children. This morning, we celebrate this momentous occasion. We take our hats off to our 6 students who have beaten the odds and made it to the top of their programs, or have exhibited excellence in service. You have gone over and beyond your call of duty, and despite the hustle and the bustle, you have stood tall. We stand proud as we witness you cross over to the alumni status. And in the words of Maya Angelou, a bird doesn't sing because it has an answer, it sings because it has a song. We hope to hear your tune from across the oceans, states and cities. We await your song of triumph and success. Ask for what you want out of life and be prepared to get it. Ask for what you want out of life and be prepared to get it.
Yes.
No dream is too big. Be a rainbow in somebody else's cloud, and remember, service to others will always be your greatest reward. Thank you again.
Good morning, everyone. I hope you're enjoying yourself. Please continue eating, and you can go get more food and go through the process. Say a few words, not much, and congratulate everybody again for getting to this milestone. This is really one of the major milestones in life when you graduate from university. There are a few like this, and you're going to basically step into the world of reality now and how things go. One thing I can guarantee you for now is that when you look back, these were the happiest time and the best time of your life. Please, true. For those of us who stay in teaching and continue, it's because we never wanted to leave the college life. So well, we. We are very proud of everybody, of course, you know, that graduate is all the time we celebrate, the parents celebrate, maybe not more relief, no more student loans or, you know, borrowing and all those things. But these are happy occasions. And of course, your achievement will be basically solidified tomorrow when you walk at commencement. But today, we are celebrating something else. That's the achievement you have in excellence, and how you became the leader of your group. We have so many students to be proud of, but this group here, to be honored, are the best of the best, and we could not be more proud. And then, you know, we would be so happy about that. Maybe I should talk louder, you know. Anyways, but to finish actually, it's not, this excellence is not about just academic GPA. All of you have demonstrated actually leadership in professionals, setting the bar high
for others, becoming a
role model for others. And that's the achievement you all have. And that's what you're celebrating. So without further ado, we are going to start calling you and sharing all the happiness with the rest of you.
Thank you, Dean. So at this stage, we're going to ask Dr. Tan, please approach as he gets ready to distribute the top student for business management.
Can you hear me? Good morning. I'm here to present a student of mine this semester based on mine during my 1 year stint at UBC. And she's definitely one of the best students I've encountered here at UBC. Her name is Lena Zekulowski. Lena is an international student from Germany. Her interest in America was sparked through her mother's stories and pictures, while her mother lived in the US, in San Diego specifically, for a few years. Her grandfather was stationed there as a pilot. So Lena enrolled in Stephen College and graduated and received her A degree in Business Technology in December 2014. Today, or I should say tomorrow, she will be receiving her bachelor's degree in Business Management. So I would like to, it is my honor and pleasure to present her with the Achievement Award in Business Management. Congratulations, Lena. Please.
Noah has accepted an offer at first year audit associate at one of the top CPA firms, Clifton Marshall Allen, and was selected to attend the upcoming AICPA Minority Leadership Workshop in Houston, Texas, to further develop as a professional. I've had the opportunity several times to see Manoa grow, to see Manoa excel. I've even had the opportunity of working with her for a whole year at a charter school, which she has left a mark. It is my pleasure, it is my honor to present this award to you, Manoa. Well done.
Entrepreneurship Award to Anthony Bailey.
Graduate Studies Director.
Good morning. Let me use my teacher voice so that you all can hear me. It is a great pleasure for me to be here for our first annual Honors Day program. And as I look at graduate studies, it's you finish the 4 years, and now you want more. And so therefore, as a part of the more, our goal is to mold you into a true professional and give you the skills and the tools that you'll need to go forward. And this shouldn't be your stopping point, you know, PhD on your way. But as we continue to look at, you know, where we are in this world, a graduate degree is one of those things, undergraduates, that you should really, really take a stock in thinking about doing, because it only continues to enhance who you are and what people see you as a person who is a doer and getting things done. So it's with great pleasure that I am going to bring up Dr. Ivanoff to give our first MBA program award.
Not yet. Do I need to speak to this?
Lucas.
Can you guys hear me?
Yes.
All right, well, I know most of you, and I'm really, I'm not use this one if you can't hear me. I know I have to read through the book, but I know most of you, and it's a real great honor to be here to give this award to Lucas, and I know Maria is here, and lots of other students are here, so. Extraordinary honor. But when I was thinking about this award, what have the students done? Well, we've done a little bit. Well, Alexander, I know some of the greatest students are really over here. What have you done? I mean, they have done a little bit, and I think that's a great achievement at our school. Some of you have done things that are not done in most of the universities that I know of nationwide. I know Lucas has published an article. And I'm not sure how many congratulations, so has Alexander. But what the award really stands for is really not what you have done, but about the future promise that you are going to do with your life going forward, and what promise, future potential that you have. And I know most of you have extraordinary ambition. I know Alexander is going to be CEO of Booz Allen Hamilton, sometime very soon in finance. I know Lucas has great ambitions, hopefully going to a doctoral school, which we will certainly support his application, or we'll go back to Czech Republic and start a great business that I know he is an extraordinary man with many different potentials. And so what we'd like to do is, as we give this award to you and to all of you, is hope that you will come back 10, 20 years from today and become great alumni, and also as you grow and start new businesses, and I know some of you will start big businesses, that you in our school certainly wants an endowment. So Lucas, support, and hopefully I'll come to your graduation as a new doctoral student or a new PhD, maybe 5, 6, 7 years from today, and welcome you back on our campus, maybe 10, 20, 15, maybe even 30 years from today. With that, where is the award? Lucas, come on up here.
Thank you.
research. For those of you who don't know Dr. Anyu, he had nothing but compliments for her presentation.
Men count with you, but really just, I couldn't do this without you guys. So I appreciate everyone in this room for everything. And thank you.
Full-time employment. He joined the National Association of Black Accountants in his first year here. He took on the roles as CREP reporter, vice president, and later one of the most effective presidents in the accounting era. Through NAVA and with the help of the UDC, he attended the Eastern Region Conference, where he secured a start and internship. The number one accounting firm in America, which is PricewaterhouseCoopers, PwC. He's very grateful to Dean Reed for taking up time of her schedule prepping for the initial interviews with PwC. Alex was also a member of the UDC Honda Trivia Challenge. That's the one I forgot. And he also hooked up with something else, the National Society of Collegiate Student Scholars, and the accounting tutor at UDC for 2 years and worked with the UDC Vita Task Clinic. And this is what I didn't tell you about, Alex. When you were working with us in the clinic, a gentleman, he was a former professor, I don't know if you remember, he came in, he was from Georgia, Washington. And he had one of the most difficult tax returns that I saw. Very difficult. Really, based on his money, he was not supposed to come to the clinic because he had a lot of money. But he was a senior citizen, and so that's why we had to do it. So I gave it to you to do, and I said I would take it and then go over it. But I was surprised he took it. He had investments, he had passive income, he had stocks, he had bonds, and you took it and you handled it. You handled it perfectly. And one more thing. We were on vacation for spring break, and I mentioned to you, I said, Alex, it would be good if you keep the clinic open during week or a half break. And you say, yes, you'll show. And you and Annabelle showed up. And I was very thankful. Because of that, we prepared over 750 tax returns that year. So thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Before you do that, we're asking all the students to please stand and take a picture.
Yes, let's go and take a photo.